In this presentation, we are going to study specific oropharyngeal and laryngopharyngeal infections. In earlier presentation, we have studied non-specific oropharyngeal and laryngopharyngeal infection, in which we have discussed acute pharyngitis and chronic pharyngitis. Now today, we will see the specific variety. In that we will see acute and chronic oropharyngeal and laryngopharyngeal infections. In acute, we will study Vincent's angina, diphtheria, the fungal infection like thrush and actinomycosis, herpes and glandular fever. And in chronic infection, we will see tuberculosis, syphilis, etc. Now let's see the first acute infection, Vincent's angina. It is also called as acute membranous pharyngitis or tonsillitis. Now what happens in the Vincent's angina? It presents as an acute ulceration and involves one or both tonsils and may spread to the pillars, soft palate and gums. So in Vincent's angina involves the tonsils, the pillars, soft palate and gums, and the pathology it present in the form of acute ulceration. The another name of the Vincent's angina, it is also called as trench mouth. Now looking at the etiological factors, the causative organism responsible for development of Vincent angina are gram-negative fusiform bacillus and spirillum, called as Vincent's organism. Certain predisposing factors which are responsible for development of Vincent's angina, like overcrowding, poor diet, general debility, that also contributes and development of the Vincent's angina. Apart from that, the dental causes like poor dental hygiene, pyorrhea, that predispose to this infection. So once the infection takes place, it will produce the clinical features like high fever, that is the first symptom to appear. Apart from that, there is a pain in the throat which is very severe. There is fetor from mouth, so there is a bad smell that is coming from the mouth. The main feature, that is grey membranous slough forms which separates and leaving a deep ulcer which destroys the tissue substantially. It involves the tonsils on one or both sides, may spread to the soft palate, pillars and gums. If you check the lymph nodes in the neck, the regional lymph nodes will produce a lymphadenitis, and it may present in the chronic form. So the acute stage subsides in a week and ulcers may persist for several months. The investigation or diagnostic technique for Vincent's angina is by hanging drop preparation of a smear. On looking at hanging drop preparation, it will demonstrate the presence of organism in the microscope. The treatment of Vincent's angina is use of antibiotics. In antibiotics, penicillin and its derivatives are helpful. Apart from that, hydrogen peroxide mouthwash and chromic acid application to the gums and ulcer is also helpful. Another acute specific infection is diphtheric pharyngitis. Nowadays, the incidence of diphtheria is reduced because of immunization. The causative organism for diphtheric pharyngitis is Cornibacterium diphtheria. It is generally seen in children between 2 to 5 years of age, and the infection spread is by airborne or by direct contact. The infection produces clinical features like raw sensation in throat, pain, and presence of diphtheric membrane. The treatment of diphtheric pharyngitis, one of the first step is to isolate the patient. It is essential so it does not spread the infection to the other person. Bed rest is advised. Apart from that, the use of antitoxin, it is given immediately if diphtheria is clinically suspected. 20,000 units per patch are given per enterally. Antibiotics like penicillin and erythromycin to control the infection. The immunization of contact should be performed, and the treatment in the form of tracheostomy is necessary in those cases who have diphtheric laryngitis with respiratory obstruction. The another infection is thrush or monalia. It is a common fungus infection caused by Candida albicans. Etiological factor, if you see, it is age wise it is seen in the usually children's. Another factor is debility, which predispose the person to development of this condition. So the person who are debilitated due to any chronic disease or who are immunocompromised, in that person there is more predisposition to development of thrush. Apart from that, prolonged antibiotic therapy that also produces or leads to a thrush. The infection produces creamy white plaques over pharynx, tongue and cheeks. You can see here there are creamy white flakes that are produced. The plaques can be easily removed with minimal bleeding, and the treatment of thrush is use of nystatin or clotrimazole solution and 1% gentian violet or silver nitrate is also helpful. The another acute specific infection is herpes simplex. It is a common viral infection. It also involves lips and face simultaneously. The characteristic lesion are small vesicles in the mouth and oropharynx. Apart from that, ulcer also develops, and the character that is painful and shallow ulcer form after the vesicles rupture. The herpes simplex, it is recurrent in the HIV patient. The treatment of herpes simplex is use of antiseptic mouthwash. Lignocaine 2% is applied before the meals, which reduces the pain. Analgesics are also useful to relieve the pain. Antiviral drug like acyclovir may be administered. In herpes zoster, vesicles appear unilaterally in a row on pharynx or palate. Pain is very severe and referred to the ear. Treatment is same as for the herpes simplex. Apart from that, steroids are useful in very painful lesions. Another acute specific infection is infectious mononucleosis, also called as glandular fever. It is a viral infection caused by Epstein-Barr virus. The infection occurs in three forms which may overlap. So in anginal form, there is presence of throat infection and pain. In glandular form, द प्रेजेंस ऑफ एनलार्जमेंट ऑफ जुग्यूडोडाइडेस्टिक एक्सिलरी एंड अदर लिम्फ नोड्स विल बी एनलार्ज. देर विल बी ऑल्सो प्रेजेंस ऑफ पायरेक्सिया एंड स्प्लिनोमेगाली. द इन्वेस्टिगेशंस हेल्पफुल फॉर डायग्नोसिस ऑफ दिस कंडीशन आर पॉल बनेल टेस्ट. इन दिस टेस्ट विल बी पॉजिटिव फॉर एग्लूटिनेशन ऑफ रेड ब्लड सेल्स ऑफ शीप बाय द सीरम ऑफ द पेशेंट. अपार्ट फ्रॉम दैट द प्रेजेंस ऑफ मोनोसाइटोसिस इज ऑल्सो देयर. द ट्रीटमेंट ऑफ ग्लैंडुलर फीवर इज सिम्टमेटिक. नाउ कमिंग टू द क्रोनिक स्पेसिफिक इन्फेक्शन. इन दैट फर्स्ट इज सिफिलिटिक फेरिंजाइटिस. नाउ सिफिलिस इज प्रेजेंटेड इन टू द प्राइमरी सिफिलिस, सेकेंडरी सिफिलिस एंड टर्शरी सिफिलिस. सो प्राइमरी सिफिलिस विल बी प्रेजेंटेड इन द फॉर्म ऑफ शैंकर, बट प्राइमरी शैंकर रेयरली अकर्स इन द फेरिंग्स. इन सेकेंडरी सिफिलिस देर इज प्रेजेंस ऑफ म्यूकस पैचिस हैविंग अ ग्रे ट्रांसल्यूसेंट सरफेस एंड सराउंडिंग कंजेशन मे बी सीन. अपार्ट फ्रॉम दैट देर इज प्रेजेंस ऑफ स्नेल ट्रैक अल्सरेशन और पैचिस. लिम्फेडिनाइटिस एंड स्किन रैश मे बी प्रेजेंट. सो दैट इज द प्रेजेंटेशन इन सेकेंडरी सिफिलिटिक फेरिंजाइटिस. इन टर्शियरी सिफिलिस द गमेटस अल्सर इन्वॉल्विंग हार्ड पैलेट, सॉफ्ट पैलेट और फेरिंग्स लिविंग बिहाइंड अ परफोरेशन एंड स्कारिंग विल बी देयर. इन स्पाइट ऑफ एक्सटेंसिव लीजन डिस्कम्फर्ट इज निग्लिजिबल. मीन्स अल्सरेशन इज प्रेजेंट बट पेशेंट विल हैव अ नो डिस्कम्फर्ट और पेन बिकॉज द सिफिलिटिक अल्सर आर जनरली पेनलेस. थर्ड ट्यूबरक्यूलोसिस और ल्यूपस ऑफ फेरिंग्स विल टेक द फॉर्म ऑफ एन अल्सर, ट्यूबरक्यूलोमा और ल्यूपस. फेरिंजियल इन्वॉल्वमेंट इज ऑलमोस्ट ऑलवेज सेकेंडरी. द टॉन्सिल्स आर बिलीव्ड टू एक्ट एज अ पोर्टल फॉर द एंट्री ऑफ ट्यूबरक्यूलर इन्फेक्शन. सो पोर्टल ऑफ एंट्री इज फ्रॉम टॉन्सिल टू जुग्युलोडाइकेस्टिक लिम्फ नोड्स. But it has been shown that tonsils harbor a very small focus of tuberculosis which infects the lymph nodes. Tonsillectomy is advocated for these cases in quiescent stage. So with this slide I end up with the topic of pharyngitis. Thank you.